January 31, 2017. Catholics send urgent plea to Trump, save us from vast Vatican-led conspiracy. By Sorka Fall, and as reported to her Western subscribers. As the fast-moving coup against Freemason leader President Donald Trump continues to roil the United States, the Security Council, SC, is reporting today that America's oldest traditionalist Catholic Church newspaper, The Remnant, has penned an open letter to their nation's new leader pleading with him to investigate what they claim is a vast Vatican Democratic Party alliance meant to not only destroy the U.S., but to also plunge our planet into World War III. Among the critical issues these Catholic stalwarts are pleading for Trump to investigate, this report notes, are, 1. To what end was the National Security Agency monitoring the conclave that elected Pope Francis? 2. What other covert operations were carried out by U.S. government operatives concerning the resignation of Pope Benedict or the conclave that elected Pope Francis? 3. Did U.S. government operatives have contact with the Cardinal Daniels Mafia? 4. International monetary transactions with the Vatican were suspended during the last few days prior to the resignation of Pope Benedict. Were any U.S. government agencies involved in this? 5. Why were international monetary transactions resumed on February 12, 2013, the day after Benedict XVI announced his resignation? Was this pure coincidence? 6. What actions, if any, were actually taken by John Podesta, Hillary Clinton, and others tied to the Obama administration who were involved in the discussion proposing the fomenting of a Catholic spring? 7. What was the purpose and nature of the secret meeting between Vice President Joseph Biden and Pope Benedict XVI at the Vatican on or about June 3, 2011? 8. What roles were played by George Soros and other international financiers who may be currently residing in United States territory? With the entire Catholic Church world shaken to its core by Pope Francis's destruction, through pacification, of the Order of Malta, Knights of Malta, for their supporting of Freemason leader President Trump, this report continues, virtually unknown to the American people is that the evil Jesuit Jorge Bergoglio's election to become Pope Francis was steeped in high corruption and that top Vatican officials are still rebelling against, and as evidenced by one of Italy's top reporters, Marco Tazzatti, writing in one of that nation's oldest newspapers, La Stampa. For these cardinals they have vowed to avenge, we will not cooperate with this whitewashing. This will not go away. It will deepen. It will not go away. His emphasis, not ours. Important to know about this vast Vatican Democratic Party alliance, this report says, is it's being funded by the self-acknowledged Nazi collaborator George Soros, who made his fortune by stealing the property of Jews prior to their being exterminated during World War II, and who today is spending hundreds of millions in his bid to destroy Freemason leader President Trump by flooding the streets of America with pathological mindless idiots in a tactic first used by German psychological intelligence operatives loyal to Adolf Hitler. Equally important to know about this vast Vatican Democratic Party alliance, this report explains, is that one of its main, central Vatican operatives named Peter Sutherland, who is the United Nations Special Representative of the Secretary General, SRSG, has been the key architect, along with George Soros, Hillary Clinton, and other globalists, of the massive scheme that has flooded Europe with the disastrous tsunami of Islamic migrants, and that Pope Francis has blessed by his stating that Islam is strengthening Europe. With Pope Francis being the first Jesuit, Society of Jesus, leader of the Catholic Church in all of history, this report continues, the reason this ancient order was not allowed to have one of its members become pontiff is due to their radical global agenda for the 21st century. And that includes, 1. Economic communism and political fascism in the American Empire, 2. Creating international anti-Jewish fury, 3. Creating international anti-Americanism, 4. Depression, anarchy, race war, martial law, foreign war and invasion, 5. Destruction of the Empire's heretic Protestants, Baptists and Jews as well as liberals, to Freemason leader President Trump's most dire and immediate crisis against this vast Vatican Democratic Party alliance, this report gravely warns, are these globalists pushing for war against Russia, World War III, in the coming weeks, and that they've begun to implement by having their allied U.S.-created neo-Nazi-led government of Ukraine begin a massive shelling of innocent Ukrainian Russian civilians, almost 2,000 times over the past 24 hours alone, and having their Nazi puppet leader Poroshenko rapidly convening an emergency session of this corrupt government to address a war he is starting himself. With Freemason leader President Trump knowing of this push for total war by this vast Vatican Democratic Party alliance, this report notes, he has, in turn, warned two Republican Party U.S. Senators, Lindsey Graham and John McCain, that they are close to starting World War III. But with Senator John McCain having been funded by George Soros since 2001, and Senator Lindsey Graham, also, being funded by George Soros, SC analysts state that they can't be depended on. And as George Soros-funded protesters in America are now saying we need to start killing people, more Trump supporters by the day beaten bloody by street mobs, and yet another mainstream journalist calling for the outright assassination of Trump, this report concludes, Freemason leader President Trump is showing no signs of backing down at all, and has even, astonishingly, filed official U.S. government election papers this week for this 2020 re-election bid, and that keeps George Soros and his Vatican allies from being able to campaign against him.